Police, please don't hurt me. I have kids.
I got you.
If they come see you, okay?
I'm gonna stay away. Yep, love you.
Let this dude speak, please.
Yeah, maybe they can tell us why they always silent. No.
Nah, would you say that like that?
I'm sorry. This is happening.
We appreciate that. We understand. You understand that we have each other's backs tonight, right?
Yes.
You understand that these officers don't need to be pulling forward.
We don't have to move.
Please order them to move back. Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
That is an ally in the force. What's your name? Pharrell.
Yeah.
Still don't know my mother used to say a long time ago, whenever there would be any really catastrophe that was in the movies or on the air, she would say, always look for the helpers. there will always be helpers, you know, even just on the sidelines. That's why I think that if news programs could make a conscious effort of showing rescue teams, of showing who medical people, anybody who is coming into a place where there's a tragedy, to be sure that they include that. Because if you look for the helpers, you'll know that there's hope.
Here's how we turned a normal protest into a massive takeover that ended up on the news. As we marched, we noticed thousands of cars that passed us that show support for the Black Lives Matter movement. And they began to stop one by one to give us energy, and that allowed us a chance to jump on the freeway safely. What happened next was amazing. We start opening the floodgates, and next thing you know, we took over the whole bridge. Overall, it was successful. We gave the cops a run for their money, nobody got hurt, and we create enough attention to show the world that San Francisco also supports Black Lives Matter. Of course, the cops cornered a lot of us and broke it up as well.
Officers, just to be clear, this is now the third time that I'm asking you for your badge and name, which I have a right to under the Freedom of Information Act and Charlotte City Law. You recognize that you are in violation of city law by not providing that on your person or informing me upon request of a citizen of this city. Just so we're on the same page, you understand that when you attack us for violating the law, you yourselves have violated the law. Just so we're all on the same page, right? We got that?
Hey, who's ready for a new president?
Fuck Donald Trump.
Hey!
Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump.
New president!
Yeah, fuck Donald Trump.
November 3rd!
Fuck Donald Trump.
You better get out,
yeah,
you
fuck Donald
you
Trump.
Better get out.
Running through these checks like the ones on my shit, so don't be
I just got back to my vehicle, parked in a lot, and the police slashed 1, 2, 3, 4 of my tires. And they've also slashed every other car that's parked in this lot's tires. Every car that's parked here has their tires slashed. Every single car. Unbelievable. I can't get home now.
What the fuck? They literally just slashed somebody.
My live stream tuned out. Oh, there it goes. They're slicing those guys' tires.
They literally just slashed somebody.
What I'm whipping up, look how I'm geeking up. I'm so fitted, I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty, I'm gonna get it. Watch me move.
is America. Don't got you slipping up. Look how I'm living up. Police be tripping up. Yeah, this is America.
No peace.
Guns in my area.
No peace.
I got the strap.
Why? Which way? Which way? Which way?
Bro, why are they revving the police up, man?
Keep it peaceful!
You don't want to hurt us. I see you right here, man. What are y'all doing?
We're good.
This is probably, I get, where you from, bro? Where you from? Where hood you from? Where?
Keep it peaceful.
He's from the projects. Did you hear what he just said? This officer is from the projects, bro. He's still a black man, and y'all doing this to black men. When you take off, listen. His cousins and nephews still have to go out and deal with the same things I got to, man. They out here trying to protect us, bro. Why we gonna tear up our own city, bro? Why we gonna tear up our own city?
You're not the problem.
If y'all tear up our city, y'all lose jobs. Y'all can go back to Dearborn, y'all can go back to Ann Arbor, y'all can go back to Ypsilanti and do this, man. Go back to the suburbs and do this. Don't do this to our city. Don't do this to our home, man.
Afghanistan, and we know what these wars are really about. And we joined the military for many reasons, because we need a college education, because we need a job, because we need health care. And then we joined the military, and they tell us that our enemies are poor people in caves in Afghanistan or poor people in the deserts of Iraq. But we've been to those countries, and we know that our enemies are not other poor people abroad. Our enemies are the people that laid us off from our jobs, that denied us health care, that make it impossible to get an education. Our enemies are not in the poorest countries on the planet, but right here in the richest one. Oh.
It's not us. It's the police. This the madness that they spark up. This is what they encourage. This is what they provoke. This is what you get out of you taking some a loved one from someone. This is what you get. You get a lot of people that's hurt, and they can't vent the right way. They can't no longer depend on the police to be here to protect us like they say they gonna do. So this is what you get. And no, it's not gonna end today. I can't tell you it's gonna end tomorrow. I don't know when it's going to end, but it's for y'all to start. We're not the ones that's killing us. Y'all killing us. We can't make a change if y'all don't change.
Oh, we
come on, y'all.
Listen, a white man just flicked a fucking cigarette butt at this man. He ain't do shit.
That's my
if
name.
That was me.
Ooh, they would have all jumped.
He's saying it.
I'm black and I'm proud.
Break it down now.
I got knees.
Listen, can I say something?
Yes, sir.
Look at me, bro.
I'm with you.
And you tell me if I'm wrong. And you tell me if I'm wrong. If you hold my hand and walk back that way,
yeah, it's going
to
be over.
They are going to go home.
Yeah.
Give us 10 minutes. Okay. 10 minutes of walking with us.
Yeah. 10 minutes.
Right? 10 minutes.
Okay. Okay.
All right. The whole squad.
Thank you. Put your hands up with me.
Okay, what I'm talking about.
Mommy, it's me. Hi, Mom. Hey, girl. Hey, Mom. Hey, yo, this is my mom. Hey, Mom. Hey, Mom. Hey, Mom. Love you. Come on, you. We see your kids.
You can see we've just been walking. They formed this little area over here. We haven't been brutalizing anything. Don't shoot! Don't shoot! Please protect us. Please cover all the protesters. God, please don't let them start violence on us. Please don't let them start shooting at— No! Stop! Stop! They're just shooting! They're just shooting at us!
You're police officers!
We gotta go! Come on! Come on!
It
only starts with you, bro.
I can see it. I can see it. You are not a bad person. But you gotta speak up.
Don't just start shooting that baton on anybody.
You gotta speak up. And you gotta use your voice. Because it's not gonna stop. It starts with you. You gotta speak up. Use your voice. I know you don't even wanna stand it. You don't even wanna stand it.